mungkin saya sudah tidur sama kebanyakan cewek dari Amerika, dari Kanada,
Austria. Did not my wife ya? Under woman ya? Then I get Holland,
Spanyol, orang Jepang,
Brazil,
Australia
juga,
Italiano,
New Zealand,
Norway,
Prancis,
Sweden,
Jerman, Swiss ya.
Wah, this is lot. We can do anything in here. You know, this is we call this paradise.
Yeah, Bali is paradise.
That we can do anything in here. So yeah. Make fun.
I would never have seen anything like that in the early days. You didn't see anybody touching in the street unless they were male and male and they were Balinese, or female with female Balinese. Even as a Western couple, it wasn't polite to walk in the streets hand in hand. Just even on that level, that's what it was like. I reckon it started as a natural meeting of, you know, boy meets girl, two different cultures meeting. Whether or not that was sex tourism or not then, I don't know. I think it was just a meeting that bloomed into something else.
And for Western women, you see Balinese, ordinary Balinese men were socially acceptable. For the first time, you see, in the 60s and 70s, yeah. Because previously, you see, they would have sex, yeah. It would always be, you see, with people from high caste, yeah.
I think I really noticed it happening early 80s. You know, you'd notice more at the airport, the boys waving one girl off and next plane in meeting another one. It is known and spoken about amongst certain people that, you know, if you go to Bali, you can find yourself a lover for a few weeks. That's well known now, but it wasn't why you went to Bali, you know, initially.
Boy, it's perhaps more specific to Kuta, but the phenomenon, you find it all over the island. Yeah. Where did the term come from? I think it was created by the people from Denpasar, you see, sometime in the 70s, yeah, by the Denpasar bourgeoisie, which disliked, you see, the phenomenon. Because yeah? These were fishermen's son, poor Balinese, going after girls and sometimes making it, so it was not accepted. Yeah. From a moral point of view, with quotation mark, as well as from a social point of view. Yeah. Thank you. like a boy, you see, he would have long hair. He would be very black, you see, almost black, you see.
Who can speak a smattering of about 5 or 6 languages. Let's just say he doesn't need to wear any clothes except his shorts, which defy gravity, and a great big smile on his face.
We mustn't think that all Balinese, you see, are Kutako boys. It's a very small minority. Yeah? It has its fame, but it's a minority. But it's a visible minority because quite a few of them have managed to make money.
Yeah, because it's, I don't know, that exactly they don't have Kutako boy. That is, I don't want to answer that exactly what it is. No comment.
No comment. Are you a Kutako boy or no answer?
So that is no comment.
I'm 50 years old, okay? I've tried to understand women. I've not understood even a percentage of that. And these little fuckers on the beach, sorry for the language, 22-year-olds and 18-year-olds, they seem to connect to these women. And the women connect to them so instantly. It is probably because when they're in their own country and they are moving around, no one gives them that attention.
Yeah, because, you know, I mean, there's a lot of frustrated Western women out there. I mean, just look at the sales of Eat, Pray, Love. I mean, the women that just don't quite know who they are or wanting something. Well, maybe life just hasn't presented the opportunities that they're looking for or the sort of men that they're dealing with in their life. A less than satisfactory or whatever.
I forgot Japanese man because my boyfriend is Balinese right now. So but I before I got married with Japanese man, so Japanese man, if feel something, don't say that. He feel emotional, so cannot explain. That's why Japanese women, they're not happy, I think.
Of course it's fun when someone's like, see you and like, wow, you look so good. In Sweden, you don't want to say that because if you say that to a girl, maybe she thinks she's too cool. Like, here you just throw a, like, if you think something about a girl, if you think she's beautiful, you're going to say it. It's nothing to be ashamed of.
So men like us from developed countries have forgotten what's the word I'm looking for? How to
appreciate a woman.
Appreciate a woman.
Yeah.
Japanese boys are very follow me, like strict. And they don't care about girls. Opposite.
You know, you see when you go back to the West how people are living and nobody cares for each other and they're all just sort of living these separate, isolated lives. And I think not everybody wants to be in that situation. Or maybe they've moved away from their families and everybody's so busy. They come here where time is slower and people pay attention to small details and it's lovely. Women don't want to be women anymore in the West. They don't want to be feminine. And I think it's a shame. So I can understand why they come here and they're searching for something and suddenly this environment provides that. You know, I guess they get to a point where they want some soft heart, sort of touchy, touchy, feely, feely, sort of softness that this environment provides. Again, it is more feminine and it's a people are sweeter and there's more smiles, just things like that make you feel good.
At least that's what you see the ladies think. What I know, you see, they try to sell paradise, actually. They try to sell Bali. And they posit themselves as being the intermediaries, you see, to get the true knowledge of the island. true knowledge of paradise, yeah? The keys to paradise, the gigolos, yeah? And they might be the keys to hell at the same time.
Aku harus dapat, kalau tidak dapat, oke, cos, pergi kamu, jangan dekat saya. Normal 3 hari harus, sebab banyak cewek di pantai, tidak hanya dia, cewek. Mengerti? Serupa.
This night from Maria, my girlfriend from Jerman, this one from Nico. Also my girlfriend from Belanda, from Australia, name I forget. Ice. This one from Sarah. What?
Fishing, buat semua orang different ya. Kalau Maitri, always joking. On the feet always blah 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 with somebody with all Madeira. Because oh you friendly blah 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 only this one. But I always friendly with somebody. Then I also make customer like service. Eh? It's good service number one. Beautiful service. I service what she want, what happened with she, then how about the last night. It's normal when she don't have small money, then I can give small money. When she want to, when I eating something, I want to try what she, you want try? Aku tawarin surfing, cause aku rent surfing ya. Then normal he tidak tahu, dia tidak mau, oh dia mau. This one I don't know ya. Then normal I try for yes, you want surfing. When dia tidak mau, then I just speak. Dari mana kamu? Only this one, then siapa nama? And you like in Bali? Yeah, and how long you in Bali? And berapa lama sudah di Bali? Only this one. Then when maybe tomorrow again? You want surfing again? Let's always this one. Then terakhir ya. What you want? What you like music? When she like hip hop, I also I know this place. When like, boom boom boom. What's his name?
House.
Yeah, house music. Also I know. Then she want this one. Ayah Rudy, I want this one. Okay. You know this one, this place? Not, I don't know. Okay, you go with me tonight on this one, if you want. But normal always mau. Always want.
Kalau gunung itu pendek, kita tuh bisa cepat. Tapi kalau gunung itu tinggi, kita tuh harus pelan-pelan. Kalau kita capek, kita harus istirahat dulu. Jalan lagi, istirahat lagi. Sama dengan tamunya. Kalau tamunya tuh tinggal di sini 4 hari, 5 hari, ya kita santai aja dulu. Mungkin kita nggak menyampaikan daripada isi hati kita, dan kita tuh diam dulu, kita snorkeling dulu. Dan nantinya setelah hari H-nya dia, the last day-nya dia, baru atau 2 hari sebelumnya kita tuh menyampaikan. Kalau tamunya tuh interesting, pasti di last day-nya itu kita tuh dapatkan. Dia pasti akan merasa, oh orang ini baik, laki ini baik kok. Setelah kita tuh bertemu udah 3 hari, dia gak terlalu agresif. Jadi saya tuh percaya sama dia.
Yeah, no, boy, smart little guys, aren't they? I think that's really true. Yeah, yeah. But, and of course, that's what women want, you know? I mean, they weren't good. If all it is sex, the women probably aren't interested in it. They want to feel that someone cares about them, you know? Whereas with guys,
Yeah, it's just all about the sex and then see you later. Wham, bam, thank you, ma'am. Whereas, no, you know, girl would want to come here probably and be with someone for the whole time and have this little romantic interlude, you know, where and feel, oh, you know, I fell in love in Bali. It was so great, you know. Whereas I think men probably are like, yeah, happened. Don't want to see her tomorrow. That's over, you know. So, yeah, and I think these boys know that. Definitely. Yeah, and they are so charming, I have to say. They are really cute.
Japanese people, like Balinese, they are friendly. They have this cute smile. People show the smile. So in Japan, many gray color building cannot show the smile. I don't know why.
When I first came here, of course it was like they're black skin, nice bodies, friendly, can surf. But now I just think they're like, they're so funny. And I don't know, they really love to just sit down with the tourists or another person just to talk, to get to know them. And I love that too, so maybe that's something we have in common, like to feel it interesting to get to know another people.
Japanese, very shy, like her, you know. They don't speak so much and they don't come closer at the first. But here, hello, 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 like, where are you going? They care about them.
And they love to have fun. You know, they'll get out and sing and dance and joke and, you know, they're funny. And they themselves are very not judgmental. You know, they'll include you in everything. They just want to have friends. And, you know, they're very safe. I think probably for a lot of the women that come here, what they're feeling is these people feel safe to them.
I think when people say these women come here for a good lay, I think basically that's a very crude way of putting it. I think it's far, far more refined than that. They are coming here to let their inhibitions go. It's a big thing for a man. It's a 2-minute spasm and it's over. For the woman, it's a day-long orgasm for them. To be on the beach, sweating in the sun, sizzling with their olive oil all over there, or their suntan oil, or whatever they put on their bodies. I've never touched them, so I wouldn't know. And then to have these other men, heavenly bodies, coming and smiling at them and treating them, whether they're fat, they're thin, they're black, they're old, whether they have hair, they don't have hair, it doesn't matter. These people come and give them that affection as a woman. They can connect with a word, with a smile, with a gesture.
When people are looking, then I can look in your eyes. Look in your eyes. What?
You have a spider in
your spider. Oh, it's okay. This brother.
From another mother.
Yeah.
Yeah, of course, you get more attention here. And yeah, they push the right buttons. I don't know how to explain it, but Western guys, it's so for them, it's so much to live up to. It's so much about looks and how you are, and you have to be someone. You have to be somebody.
Yang penting uangnya bagus, bukan fish. Apa nama wajah? Uangnya bagus, ya bagus.
Waktu SMA, cita-cita saya ingin jadi polisi. Tapi waktu itu, nilai exam saya kurang bagus, dan saya tidak jadi. Pas waktu itu, orang tua saya sakit, dan tidak ada uang. Dulu saya tidak ada pekerjaan lain, so saya langsung belajar di pantai. Saya lihat teman saya banyak yang bawa cewek, gitu saya tertarik untuk belajar bahasa Inggris, gitu.
I looking for job, so difficult before. This one, I think 4 months. 4 months I sleep in place. Then I see my friend working in, on the beat. Then he so he talk about working. When you want, you working in on the beat. This my friend. Yeah, then I go for sell minuman, you know. I jualan minuman 3 bulan atau 4 bulan around this one ya, yeah? I forget. Then it's normal every day I just borrow my friend surfing for play surfing. Then I looking when somebody teacher surfing, then I also can also belajar surfing.
Setiap malam saya belajar bahasa Inggris pakai kamus. Pakai kamus, dua kata setiap hari, dua kalimat saya belajar. Dan saya langsung praktek paginya. Saya belajar yang penting-penting aja seperti kata-kata sailing, fishing, trekking, rain masker, seperti itu. Untuk biaya hidup saya.
Dan from minuman, go surfing ya. Ah, this one I stop. Looking, and lesson speak and how I can handle tourists. This stop, pitch point. It's pitch point. Sometime 50,000 one day, sometime don't have money, sometime tidak pasti, but it's enjoy, ya, yeah? Enjoy and it's good, and looking for girl also is good, and belajar banyak bahasa. I love you, this English, German ich liebe dich, Frances atuh two time, Holland ich hoffe you, well, Spain I forget. Sizer, I forget weekly. Spend with Mandarin, I forget. Sizer.
Untuk saya jual paket. Kebanyakan saya tidak langsung tanya langsung kamu harus bayar, saya tidak langsung saya begitu. Awalnya saya hanya menjual cinta, tapi kalau dia sudah tinggal lama lain masalahnya.
Itu benar, kalau sudah dapat, kalau dia satu bulan di sini aku semua free satu bulan, tidak bayar rumah, tidak bayar makan, everything tidak bayar. Then when she go home, then always give me money for eating for 1 month, then sometime for rent, for bayar rumah for 3 bulan, 4 bulan.
Yang baru ada satu hitam, satu putih.
Ah, ya, yeah. I want to yang hitam. Post buat money.
For me.
Betul. Ya, because every day you always pay for me. Pay something, yes. Something eating, something for me. All. No worries, man. I was clever about that.
Si, go belanja ini, belanja. Shopping. What she belanja? When she belanja only 25.000, 35.000 for t-shirt. Okay, cus. Bye bye.
Terus cari yang lain.
Cari yang lain.
Karena ada banyak di pantai.
Ada banyak. Steam ya. It's true.
Kalau saya berpikir saya lebih baik cari orang yang lebih tua dan punya penghasilan. Kalau cewek muda mungkin cuma 2 hari, 3 hari di sini dia langsung pergi karena tidak dia banyak punya banyak uang, karena mungkin dia baru selesai sekolah, dia langsung traveling, dia cuma cukup untuk makan dan minum saja di Bali. Cewek tua dia pertamanya saya tidak suka sama saya karena dia bilang, tidak, kamu masih muda, kamu seperti anak saya, I don't care. Kamu lihat kalau yang coconut lebih fresh, all coconut mat oil, like. Saya bilang begitu sama cewek dan jalan sama saya.
I have had boys approach me. I have had them say that to me. I'm very committed to my family. I have a wonderful husband. I've been with him for almost 30 years, and I have two wonderful children. So I'm never interested in that, and they know that.
If you're a bit older, oh no, but you're still so young, so strong. Oh no, no, oh no, we like older women here, blah, 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 you know. And obviously it must work somewhere.
When she go back in Bali, then she always before go in Bali take email or the SMS, then I can take a taxi from airport. All girl after with me. Yeah, only this one. Then like this, you know, from German. 1 week ago, 4 days ago, she go home. Yeah, you know. In September, she coming again.
So she's gonna call you and.
Yep. Normal.
There are people just staying here for 2 or 3 weeks, maybe more, but not that much. So like having the girls for 3 weeks and then she's gone. And she will tell him if she wants to come back, so he already knows when she's coming back, so he's not getting a new girl then. Got it?
When sama dia ke Rudi aku bulan Juli datang, oke Rudi aku bulan Juli datang, dan aku ada hanya bicara jangan bulan Juli yang satu, ke satu ya, karena bulan Juli banyak hujan and kotor. Next month. Then one girl coming, this next one coming. Only this one, I'm not stupid, Rudy.
Dulu saya pernah ada cewek, pas waktunya sama, bulannya sama, dia datang juga ke WW sama, same time. Saya bingung gimana harus ini, teman saya tinggalin aja dia. Yang satu, kalau yang mana lebih cantik, itu aja yang saya urus gitu. Kalau yang satunya cuma jelek begitu, gendut seperti itu, saya tidak peduli sama yang satu. Saya bilang sama teman saya, kamu lihat ini juga. Yang penting kamu tidak ngomong apa-apa masalah tentang saya sama cewek.
You have to think something about that.
For what?
Like, if there can be someone else or not. Or is it not possible?
Not possible.
Not possible? So why did you cheat on me last year?
That before me, you say?
The Swedish girl was between.
Yeah. I don't know. Dia aja lah yang jawab.
Okay, sorry, I'm a bit confused. So there's a French girl and a Swedish girl.
The
Swedish?
Yeah.
Did I get email from Sweden?
Yeah.
Swedish? No. Just France?
No.
From France?
No. Swedish? I'm sure it was Swedish or Norwegian or something from up there.
Maybe.
It's a long time ago, I've never been in touch again.
Yeah.
For foreign woman, come here, the problem about the money. Belgium already 2 years have experience with local boy, first, this local boy want motorbike. And he got. The local boy very clever. Have repair place with the really broke motorbike. When the girlfriend come, and the girlfriend ask where the motorbike. And the local boy is very angry. I say to you, must be buying a car. Why you give? You buy me a motorbike. You know, I got a big accident. And she say, okay, this is, I'm wrong to you. And she buy the car.
And then after the car, buy a plane.
Of course, how normal.
Banyak teman saya yang berbohong, saya bilangin, dia bilangin bapak saya sakit, ibu saya sakit, atau nenek meninggal, dia bohongin, begitu ada juga begitu. Kebanyakan kalau dia, kita sudah nanya, dia sudah pernah tidur sama seseorang atau sama saya, kalau saya minta uang, kita punya alasan tepat, dia pasti kasih.
When I get only, I want to know your place, then I call my friend. Put nothing in their place, like PCB, like sound system, or like food.
Why?
Yeah, because I don't have something. Then the girl, okay, I give you money. Or buy this one, buy this one, buy this one.
Then you end up, girl, dia juga beli DVD, then you have two.
No, normal. She give you money.
Oh.
Okay, then I'm educated at you.
You buy television?
Yeah, television at you.
The woman buy the land with the local boy names after has certificate issuing. The local boy say, no, I have no have relationship with you. Who are you like this?
Listen, this is Asia, okay? Get one thing straight. If you come to Bali, you want to get laid, you want to have a nice guy, you pay for it. Everything costs you. Nothing is free. There's no such thing as a free fuck or a free meal or a free breakfast. You pay for it. If you run out of money, if there is a residue of love or affection or whatever, which in most cases they're not, he walks out.
Motorcycle kamu?
Cewek yang bayar dari Australia. Sekarang ada masalah sedikit karena dia sudah lebih tua. Jalan pikir saya sama dia lain gitu. Mungkin saya akan stop sampai di sini. Mungkin saya cari lagi gitu. Saya punya cewek lagi. Karena hidup saya sudah glamor atau biasa bikin banyak ada uang, langsung saya spend, minum atau cari cewek. Itu sudah biasa.
Asking me whether the Kuta cowboys are good for the economy. They're part of the economy, man. They're part of the gross national product. Sorry. They generate land deals, buying and selling of houses running into hundreds of thousands of dollars. The motorcycle industry, the restaurants, the businesses here.
I think without them, I think a lot of Bali's economy may not be there.
Suami saya kerja di pantai cari tamu cewek. Saya enggak marah sama suami saya. Om Roy datang, dia bersama tamu. Satu hari, dua hari, saya nggak tidur sama suami saya. Saya nggak apa, karena saya nggak punya apa-apa kebutuhan anak saya. Saya nggak sekolah, saya nggak bisa baca.
Kalau anak saya minta sesuatu dan dia langsung minta sama saya, istri saya minta sama saya, dan karena saya tidak punya uang, kebetulan nggak ada tamu di pantai, saya bilang sama tamu saya, pacar saya, bahwa saya butuh uang untuk beliin anak saya sepatu, baju untuk sekolah, dan langsung saya email tamu saya, dan tamu saya kirimin uang, dan saya berikan sesuatu untuk kebutuhan istri dan anak-anak saya.
Sudah ketemu cewek tamu ini?
Ya, saya sudah ketemu, tapi saya tersenyum sama cewek itu.
Ini kebanyakan pengalaman teman saya yang sudah punya istri. Dia masih berprofesi mencari cewek. Dulunya istrinya marah. Marah karena tidak ada materi, belum ada materi. Dan setelah dia mungkin itu cowok ketemu sama cewek kaya, dia dibelikin rumah, dibeliin mobil. Cewek langsung drastis, dia langsung lembut sama itu cowok.
Local boy, local wife, but he has, local boy have this relationship with this woman, foreign woman.
And the wife doesn't mind? The wife knows?
This isn't a good question, because she come here, I have relationship 3 years. But why? The woman and the wife not protest, not jealous. And I say, this is trick. Because why until 3 years? Because the target is mean to renovate it, the house, not yet finished.
Apa namanya?
Ada Devi.
Devi?
Ya, Devi Erlina.
Sama ini?
Wayan Artama.
Saya lebih suka melihat dia ke pantai, cari tamu.
Kalau dia kerja di kantor atau proyek atau apa-apa, nggak bagus?
Nggak.
Kenapa?
Karena dia sakit. Kalau di proyek itu lebih berat dari di pantai.
Tapi ini suami kamu jalan-jalan sama tidur sama cewek luar, tidak apa-apa?
Saya nggak apa-apa. Saya kasih dia.
Contohnya, nanti kalau saya sudah punya istri, saya ketemu cewek atau bule tua, dia banyak punya uang. Kalau istri saya, dia mau cerai, silakan cerai. Saya tidak peduli. Masih banyak cewek yang antre di belakang saya bilang begitu. Kalau kita petani tidak bisa apa-apa, tidak ada penghasilan mungkin 10.000 per hari. Kita proyek building 30.000 per hari. Mancing kadang-kadang tidak dapat ikan. Dan di community ada banyak tanggung jawab. Saya harus bayar begini, bayar begitu. Saya berpikir sama uang. Keluarga saya harus hidup. Adik saya sekolah, saya bilang begitu. Ini pura saya bikin 6 bulan yang lalu. Kira-kira menghabiskan uang 15 juta. Sama langsung sama pura. Pura di atas ada 3 saya beli. Ini rumah, Pak. Ini tempat rumah bapak saya sekarang. Sama adik tinggal, sama sister-in-law dan anaknya.
And how much did it cost you?
Untuk bikin rumah ini kira-kira saya dulu habiskan sekitar 45 juta. 45 juta saya spend together with my brother and then some people helping also from Holland. Dan ini rumah saya yang kedua, ini my own house. Untuk nanti saya, kalau saya kawin, saya akan tinggal di sini sama istri saya.
Saya tidak malu punya anak cari-cari cewek di pantai. Bisa membantu orang tua, saya bangga.
Ada soal satu lagi, jangan marah, saya sendiri mau tanya. 10 tahun atau 15 tahun depan, kalau anak laki kamu kerja sama seperti Roy, kamu sakit hati atau bagaimana?
Enggak. Saya senang kalau anak saya kerja di pantai seperti Wayne Roy.
Hi girls, where are you from? I think I know you from last night. what you do? What are you doing tonight? If you have any planning, you can come with me tonight. I love you.
Saya pecinta wanita. Saya mencintai wanita. Saya bukan seorang gigolo. Mereka tidak pernah berbicara dengan hati, tapi mereka berbicara dengan otak. Seorang gigolo. Tapi saya berbicara dengan hati. Pertama kali saya bicara dengan hati.
Karena saya suka interesting sama dia pertama. Saya mau making love pertama. Mau saya, karena saya masih muda, saya perlu making love.
But you make money.
I not make money. I never ask give me money. Give me money, not.
But they give you money.
But I not give you. That way I start working. Then I have sex when I have fun or I like it with girl. Really I interest with girl. Then I want to sex with girl.
No, I don't think they're really gigolos. I think they just love women. There's nothing wrong about that. But it's just about the cheating stuff, like you're really, they really love when you're here and they really love you and like that. It's just when you leave, they maybe find someone else. But when you're here and when you have a boyfriend or a girlfriend, it's for real.
Hidup di daerah Kuta, mungkin semua sudah tahu, khususnya untuk local boys, kenalan paling tidak mereka pingin kenalan sama cewek asing di luar orang Indonesia.
Yeah, I think it's Western is more fun.
Yeah,
yeah.
Because
because
they more freedom than local, you know.
This is more freedom and then they more fun.
Yang cewek yang paling suka cewek Prancis, paling romantis saya suka. Kan kebanyakan kalau saya ketemu sama cewek sudah mabuk gitu, dia pingin langsung main. Tidak ada romantisnya, tidak ada ciumannya sedikit. Kalau cewek Prancis, dia enggak suka minum, kadang-kadang enggak, dia minum. Dia bawa saya ke pantai, ajak ke pantai sambil lihat bulan, bintang itu. Dia ciuman, bikin api, saya bikin api. Ciuman sampai puas, sekitar satu jam setengah saya ciuman. Baru.
Anyone know, I think, ya. Saya tahu, saya mungkin semua orang tahu kalau pernah berhubungan dengan seorang cewek Jepang, perempuan Jepang, mereka akan merasakan dia seorang laki-laki, betul-betul laki-laki. Karena orang Jepang, oh, maniac sex, ya. I am making love, ya, yeah. Like the making love, and then dia bilang, kimochi, kimochi, oh, dia bilang seperti itu, and then maybe you know, mean the kimochi, ya, yeah. It's mean kimochi, I'm enjoy, so really, really enjoy, ya, yeah, like that, and then I say, oh, good, atasi mau kimochi ka, so I say like that, and then I more speed, ya, yeah. Saya lebih speed do ya, and then dia bilang, oh iku asa like that, oh my god, ah, dia sudah bilang iku, saya seperti, oh saya the boy, saya really laki-laki ya, saya so I'm very happy ya for me ya, dia bilang iku. And then saya juga sudah iku juga waktu itu, saya juga I drop something ya. Oh bagus sekali.
Almost sama. Sama nakal, sama semua, sama. Almost.
If you wanna have sex, go and have sex. But do it for yourself. Not just because he wants to. And don't be ashamed that you like it. Like, guys like it and they tell you, I like to have sex, they do it all over the world, so why cannot women do it?
I would think with a lot of women coming here, they can do that, have a good time and go home, and no strings attached a lot of times. And boy, that's what a lot of men want to do, you know? So again, I guess it's kind of roles reversed, but women are working, they're stressed too, they do a lot, they have a lot on their plate. Maybe this is a way for them to have that without commitment, et cetera, and then go home and get back to their life if that's what they want to do. Although I think a lot of times they really wish they could take that guy home with them, and sometimes that does happen.
Now Japanese women is so strong, so about money, working. So before, the salary is low, a woman's salary is low. So, but the Japanese rule changed. The women and men is the same, equal. So that's why Japanese women has a vacation. That's why their feeling is high tension. That's why a Balinese boy is kind of friendly, easy to have a relation. So, but I don't like that.
Orang Jepang katanya apa ya, majime. Majime itu istilahnya apa ya, orang-orang baik gitu ya kan. Kalau dulu dia masih pakai kehidupan Jepang. Adatnya sebenarnya lebih kuat Jepang itu. Kalau di Bali kan udah hancur campuran juga ya kan. Adat bule, adat Jepang, adat mana gitu. Udah nggak ada peraturan lagi. Kalau di kehidupan pariwisatanya gitu.
If you're sleeping around in Sweden, you get a bad reputation, but here, yeah, of course you can get a bad reputation, but it's more fun here. Like, you should appreciate sex, it's a good thing to have. Why shouldn't you, like? But yeah, they're really good in bed.
Only satu jam main.
Nanti balik ke rumah?
Enggak, satu jam main lagi, udah keluar satu kali, dan berdiri lagi, main lagi. Until 3 kali, finish. Not more. It's enough. Sometimes 2 or 3 is enough. For kesehatan.
See, the Kuta cowboys are very special people and I admire them. If I can even be 5% of who they are, I'd probably be a man.
We are talking with my Swedish friends here about just the sex here. And this is amazing because in Sweden it's like, okay, now I'm really open-minded, I'm just gonna tell you, but if a guy goes down on you in Sweden, they like think, oh, now I'll get down on her, she's gonna go down on me. Like, it's all about equal, like, if you do that, I'm gonna do that, and then that. But here, they want to do stuff on you, they can ask you, please, just let me go down on you, I really want that. And I said, no, I'm tired, but just let me do it.
Yeah. I think especially they say my client the hot, not the big of the dick, yeah, but the hot, even little but very strong like paku dulu.
Male.
Yeah, because the big dick for foreigners must be harus dipegangi untuk masuk di lubang ya. Tetapi ini tidak.
Because some guys are really small here, so they get small sizes of the dicks. And in Sweden, if you have a small dick, you go and like you're so insecure, you don't maybe don't want to have sex, and you feel bad. Here, you do something about it. You get a piercing.
Have to show you. You need that?
No, I'm not mine.
Okay. Well, you can tell me.
I'm not mine. Come on. I'm not mine.
Okay, later.
The special for my cock, I put something inside the skin. Okay, I put this. I get like this. Potong. saya alusin, amplas, kasih odol, alus, sepeda bulat seperti ini.
Dibuka, udah gitu diiris pakai silet, udah ada lubang, mutiara yang udah jadi dimasukkan. Anda sambil sikat yang udah tajam, didorong pakai yang ini, set, udah masuk, lepas sikat, ambil kopi, lubang yang tadi itu ditutup pakai kopi.
4 days, 4 night, no sour. Waiting until they grow. After 5 days, you can use it. And then, one thing, I put head or horse, I put here, before I put ring. And then I try with the girls, the first time, the girls love that. And then I take picture for my coke. Maybe my coke everywhere, you know, because a lot of girls take picture. It's done. No, I'll show you what it's at.
No problem. You have the picture?
Huh?
You have the picture?
Well, on CD, I have to open the CD. But I have no problem, I don't mind. Yeah, it's my coke.
Because my client 90% woman, sad with problem, truly problem or with the boyfriend, I make it my formula. I must be have stone, especially for woman to wake up her spirit. This stone make it the vibration. The vaginas will be attractive. The funny stone also like vaginas.
Sorry, the stone does what? It makes her vagina attractive.
Yes.
To men.
Yes. Yes.
Attractive mean it moves.
Make it the hallucination. Make it the imagination when falling in love of this gentleman will be like in the paradise. Yeah.
And do a lot of women buy the stone?
No. Buy it must be touched. There is only one. This.
They touch it with what?
This to make it the vibration. This is only in the media to transferring the believer will be in her character. My vagina is a good quality like this.
Okay. And then when they come back, do they say thank you for the stone? It really works.
Of course.
Biasanya saya pakai safety sack seperti kondom. Kadang-kadang saya tidak pakai alat kondom, mungkin kalau saya terlalu mabuk berat dan itu cewek tidak kontrol juga, saya tidak memakai kondom. Dan orang yoga yang belajar yoga meditasi, kebanyakan kalau sudah tahu saya atau dia percaya sama saya, kebanyakan dia tidak mau pakai kondom karena dia percaya sama dirinya dia bahwa saya itu energinya bagus dan dia tidak mau pakai alat kontrasepsi. Saya tidak pernah itu testing, tapi saya percaya saya masih sehat, tidak ada penyakit. Saya berpikir kebanyakan karena orang Eropa mungkin lebih sehat daripada orang Asia karena dia lebih rajin ngecek alat kelaminnya ke rumah sakit itu.
Jadi kasus AIDS yang pertama dilaporkan di Indonesia sebenarnya itu ditemukannya adalah di Bali ya. Itu tahun 1987 ya. Kebetulan waktu itu adalah turis asing yang kebetulan ada di Bali. Lalu saya dengan teman-teman di Rumah Sakit Sanglah dan Fakultas Kedokteran Udayana lalu ingin mencari tahu ya sebenarnya oke, sudah ada kasus AIDS pada orang asing, bagaimana sebenarnya Bali ini ya, sampai di mana sudah masalah HIV itu ada di Bali ya. Pada waktu itu kami mengumpulkan sekitar 400 sampel darah ya, dan ternyata ada satu yang positif dan itu adalah orang Bali. Jadi orang Indonesia, jadi bukan masalah hanya turis yang terkena HIV begitu ya. Saya disuruh belajar ke Australia melihat kasus-kasus HIV AIDS di sana. Wah, di mana tahun 87 itu sudah banyak kasus-kasus yang di rumah sakit. Saya belajar dari itu, wah kalau sampai di Indonesia kasusnya seperti ini. Di mana cari rumah sakit ya? Kita tahu fasilitas, kapasitas rumah sakit di Indonesia, di Bali khususnya itu sangat sedikit. Tidak boleh pesimis, oke. Tapi saya masih khawatir kalau masyarakat masih bersikap tertutup, tidak mau terbuka, tidak mau jujur pada kondisi yang memang ada di Bali, itu penularan akan makin meluas. Iya, seperti yang ditulis di mungkin tsunami AIDS katanya setelah 5-8 tahun ke depan dari sekarang.
The third Norwegian girl. What's the name of his her boyfriend?
Rio.
No, it's not Rio, the other one. He just came back from Norwegian.
Oh, Ali.
Ali. He was in Norwegia, right? And Rio, I think, waiting to go to Norwegia. So, yeah. And Bubut was to France. Bubut is another friend of us. He got now, where's she from? Canada?
America.
America. He got an American girlfriend, but they're staying here together now. They got like a shop, like a Vespa shop. But he had another girlfriend in France and he went there some years ago. But I don't know, I didn't speak to him so probably, so I can't really tell, but I think Fanny knows. Last year, they're already asking when you get married and stuff like that. It's kind of serious to see the parents, but it's not like a promise, like, okay, I saw your parents, now I have to marry you. But
for me, it's, you know, I understand because you're still young.
Yeah.
And there's many planning to do it. But for me, I'm ready whenever. When you're asking me or I'm asking you, whenever I'm ready. I just respect because you still, you know, like in university.
Yeah.
And then many planning about your future maybe or something.
Sekian banyak perempuan yang pernah saya ajak tidur, dia Japanese, orang Jepang. Ada satu orang yang betul-betul pingin, saya kira dia tuh betul-betul love me, and then me love her, cinta dia juga. Dia menawarkan saya untuk pergi ke Jepang.
She really love me, ya. Yeah. Until Rudy, you won't go in my country, I'm leaving her. Yeah, normal, yeah, I won't. Because I want to know culture in other country, yeah. Europe. In Europe. Yeah, I won't. Then she give me too much money for make everything. Like passport, visa, deposito, plane. I married. Yeah, I married. Then I study. I teach cursus bahasa Jerman. Then I go school. Cause my elder and my Frau, my wife, mau aku sekolah for have apa? Sertifikat sekolah from there. Then have good salary.
Dan dia bilang, saya akan carikan kamu kerjaan di sebuah restoran, dia bilang seperti itu. Kemudian singkat cerita, saya bekerja di sebuah restoran di daerah Shibuya. Kira-kira 6 bulan training, acting like that, ya. Tapi ternyata sistem kerja di Jepang itu beda. Starting kerja sudah, kamu sudah, kita sudah mendapatkan suatu salary. Tapi saya tidak tahu. Kemudian saya bertanya kepada manager. Manager bilang bahwa saya sudah start mulai kerja, saya sudah mendapatkan salary. So, kenapa saya bilang seperti istri saya tidak bilang kalau saya sudah mendapatkan salary. Dia bilang, waktu kamu di Bali, saya kasih kamu uang sangat banyak. Dia bilang seperti itu. Kemudian dia mengeluarkan like the receipt, ya, receipt. Setiap dia datang ke Bali, dia beri saya uang itu semua ada catatan. And then total saya masih kurang memberi dia uang. Oh, waktu itu saya sangat-sangat sedih. Ternyata waktu itu saya baru merasa dia ngajak saya ke Jepang untuk bekerja supaya dia tidak perlu bekerja lagi. Tanpa sepengetahuan dia, saya bekerja pada waktu di tempat yang berbeda. Kemudian di sana ada seorang cewek Jepang juga. Dia lebih tua 10 tahun daripada saya waktu itu. Saya cerita semua saya cerita. Kemudian dia merasa kasihan dengan saya. And we have the promise, ya. Saya punya perjanjian dengan dia. Kemudian singkat cerita, saya kembali ke Bali waktu itu. Saya sudah balik ke Bali, and then sampai di Bali saya telepon, saya ring her, istri saya pertama, saya bilang, Tomoko, sekarang saya sudah ada di Bali. And then mungkin dia tuh sangat terkejut waktu saya telepon dia, karena saya sudah ada di Bali waktu itu. Dia tidak bisa melakukan sesuatu yang jelek dengan saya. Kemudian kurang lebih sekitar 2 minggu kemudian setelah saya ada di Bali, si Harumi menjemput saya ke Bali. Ya, si the second wife, Maharumi. Dia jemput saya ke Bali, and then saya seperti honeymoon di Bali, ya, with the second wife, ya. Saya seperti berbulan madu kembali di sana dengan dia. Lalu kira-kira dia tinggal di Bali dengan saya sekitar 1 month, ya, 1 bulan. Kemudian kita sama-sama kembali ke Jepang.
I think for them, they do see that, boy, if maybe a nice Australian or French girl or American girl took them to their country, they could be set for life. But it doesn't always work that way because the culture is so different.
These guys, because of their rural background, think that if they go with a white woman, they will go in an airplane and they will be in another aisle, another place, and they can travel. But they don't realize that you have to pay for everything there. They suddenly, the whole dream bursts. They suddenly realize they can't do what they're doing here in Bali.
Itulah, judulnya itu harus cinta. Jadi kalau cinta, dimanapun, mau sulit makanannya, tinggalnya dingin, atau apa, kalau dia ada di sana, ya pasti betah. Pasti senang aja. Jadi kalau dia menikah bukan karena nengok dia kaya atau apa, pasti cinta dia, gitu.
If I would marry a guy from here, I would never take him to Sweden because that would never work. It depends what he works with here. Maybe it's a serious job here, of course he can come to Sweden. But if you marry a beach boy, no. That would just be stupid, and it would be like kind of sad for him too to really feel like, oh, I can do this, I can go to Sweden, earn money, get a good life, or a more money life. And then you come back and feel like I didn't succeed. That just mean to do that.
Ya, kehidupannya lain, ya. Kalau di sana harus kerja, ya kan. Berat kerjanya. Hard work katanya, ya kan, kata orang bule gitu. Orang bule aja pengen tinggal di sini.
So if you did get married, it would be you who would move here.
Yeah. Because I think I could do it, but I don't think you could do it.
I think he would just crash in Germany. Like, also, like, I can survive here because I've been here already and I speak the language and all the stuff. If I would be here, I already got some friends here.
Because they have different illusions, you see. One of them, you see, is dreaming about the coconuts and the Asian paradise. The other one is dreaming about the lights of the city, you see. So they don't share the same world, yeah.
Putus waktu itu kita punya suatu like the commitment, ya. Yeah. Dia, my wife, the second wife, never stay in Bali. Dia tidak mungkin bisa tinggal di Bali. Dan saya juga never stay in Japan, cause saya dengan dia it's a really very different culture, ya. Yeah.
Sekolah until 4 tahun, but now only 1 tahun then I finish. Tidak mau sekolah lagi. Every day only stress. Every day. Not only, not all from Europe, yeah, but me. Me only stress about sekolah then about I miss in Indonesia. I don't like her. First time I don't like, yeah.
Kenapa kawin?
Yeah, because I want to know in there. For I have traveling in Europe. Only this one, I want. Tapi saya suka dia kalau dia masih tinggal mau tinggal di Bali.
Tapi dia tidak mau.
Dia mau, tapi nunggu 2 tahun lagi.
So mungkin 2 tahun lagi dia kembali bisa.
Bisa together in here. But I think this next month or I think next month he coming. Next month not fishing, yeah.
Okay. Tapi dia tahu kamu masih jalan-jalan sama cewek lain, main-main sama cewek lain.
Dia atau? Tahu for I no stress. Dia tahu. Aku jalan sama orang lain, dia juga tahu. Cause dia don't believe in I not jalan with orang lain. Cause dia tahu aku when dia bicara ya. Dia bicara aku so friendly with orang lain. Dan normal orang lain suka sama kamu dan kamu bisa bicara, jalan sama orang lain. Dia sudah understand this one.
Terus kalau dia juga mau jalan-jalan sama cowok lain?
Ya biarin aja dia jalan-jalan sama cowok lain. Karena aku nggak tahu. Ya kan? Normal. When aku bicara jalan sama orang lain, dia juga bicara sama orang lain. Normal. This is Europe in there and in here Indonesian and I beach boy. Normal maybe me too much girl than him than she. Maybe I too much sex with many girl.
More sex than she's having.
Yeah, I think cause she, I know she cause she so he don't like when he love somebody he don't like with play with orang lain.
Tapi kamu?
Ya normal, I play when I like it. Normal.
I'm here like on holidays. I'm relaxed. I don't have to do anything. I'm not working. But now it's like we haven't seen us for like 1 year. So I mean, it would be okay if there would be something. I mean, like, because you never know what the other one is doing.
So you can see other people when you're not in Bali?
I can what?
You can see other people when you're not in Bali, when you're back in Austria or Germany?
Germany?
No.
Yeah. It's like kind of an open relationship.
I don't really know what's the real meaning legend, you know. I think newcomer come to the bait because I'm more longer than them and I'm still alive, still energetic like them, you know, like young people. And then they call me legend. But I don't really know what's the real meaning legend. Just because
Like my little brother, they call me like that, yang with brother, you know.
So you've been to New Zealand?
Yes.
What were you doing then?
Selling some silver, straw, wood carving.
How long were you there?
First time only 15, because visa is 15 days. First time.
And then?
And then second time, I can't remember. I'm bad memory guy for that.
But you were there with your girlfriend? Or your
no
wife?
Real girlfriend. See, because he's Catholic, they can't divorce. Of course, I want to have a wife, you know.
Then after New Zealand, you went to Paris,
yes.
Paris.
Yes.
What were you doing there?
Painting, study painting in MoMA. Nineteen ninety-eight,
maybe. Also with a girlfriend?
Not girlfriend. When they like, they like. They want to do what they were gonna do. A lot of women then want. They don't want. Pregnant because they really want independent, you know. Just be nice, all right, be nice. Having business, why not?
So she took Mba to Paris, but then she left you?
No, stay there with her. And that's how I realized, you know, like what European life. Nice weather, I can sit everywhere. What I mean is, I couldn't find there. And my partner working, I just stay alone, nobody talk to me.
Cheers, Bobby.
Yeah, right. For your holiday.
Yeah, happy holidays.
I have lived together 2 years.
With the New Zealand one?
No, Australian. But the still the same, I mean, still different style of life as well. Please make the character, you know.
So why never marry a local when you came back?
No idea.
I'm still struggling right now. I'm trying to looking rich hard, you know, like really good girl, you know, something. It's really hard to find a good girl here, really. Because, I don't know what's that. Especially for Western people, it's really hard. Because sometimes they are only like stay one night or something because they are on vacation here, you know? So, but I'm still looking for that. I'm still looking because I'm 26 right now, so.
26?
Yeah.
26?
Yeah. So start thinking for future, you know?
Yeah, sometimes, you know, I feel like also scared, you know, like now I'm 27.
Yeah.
If I'm more than 30 years old,
yeah.
Not so easy right now. Maybe right now, when I want that girl,
yeah.
I'm still even really hard to catch her, but I still can do it.
Okay.
Because still young, I feel it.
Yeah.
When more than 30, like 35, difficult.
Yeah. I don't know.
Now, do you feel lonely? You don't miss companionship?
That's what I told to you with emotion. If you can handle your emotion, it's all right. And your body tired, you need to take rest. And I give my body a good time for my body to take rest.
I have known, you see, cowboys, yeah? Well, in their 50s and they have in their 60s, dancers again, yeah. Dancers, because there's the aura, you see, of something different. By the beach, yeah, perhaps if they do not perform the way they used to, yeah, perhaps it's slightly different, you see. It's a ruder kind of relationship, I guess, yeah.
paradise. We call that this paradise.
Yeah,
Bali is paradise.
Yeah, that we can do anything in here, so yeah. Make fun.
Yeah.
Well, there's always been that sort of that element anyway. I mean, women coming here looking for young boys, I mean, that's been around for forever, really. So I think it's all to do with media and how you present a place anyway. I think everyone knows it's not really paradise, but for those women, I guess it is. I don't know.
I'm always on the beach. Boy life. Some they have good luck, but some they have bad luck. People more see when the beach boy find a customer and maybe rich, you know, play some drink, look happy, blah blah blah. But different side is different. And customer just sitting 2 hours, you know, and they don't know what I'm gonna do.
Sama cewek luar sampai 3 kali. When aku sudah nikah 3 kali, punya 3 istri, cewek luar. Then finish, not fishing, not cari cewek lagi, then make business, good business.
Okay, kenapa 3?
Aku punya planning, when 3 cewek luar 1 tahun ada 12 bulan. 3 bulan di sini, 3 bulan di sini. 3 bulan di sini dan next in Java.
Istri yang nomor 4?
No, with my elderen, with my family.
You remember that fucking Cat Stevens song? Do you want to do? Don't be too much rude. Just before I done before you. And then before you grow up too. Now your turn. Let me go
away. Saya umur 18, 20 tahun, saya cari cewek itu apa dari Jepang.
Kenapa?
Kata teman-teman saya, kalau udah umur 20, 18, saya cari teman-teman saya tuh mau cari cewek yang dari luar terus ikut ke luar negeri.
Tapi kamu tahu ada sudah pernah teman yang sudah sukses begini? Sudah dapat cewek dari luar?
Sudah ada, tapi belum sukses dia.
Masih try?
Ya.
Thank you.
Thank you.